This is New Day Northwest. Now, here's Margaret Larson.
How are you doing this morning? Good to see everybody. Good morning and welcome to New Day Northwest. Happy Monday, and boy, are we enjoying this amazing weather. A quick look outside with sunny skies and mostly clear all week, according to the King 5 Weather Department. So please enjoy this magnificent springness. Coming up today, entertaining expert Heather Christo joins us with some creative and very easy DIY gift ideas for the special mom in your life. Do not forget that Mother's Day is this Sunday the 13th. Molly Moon has come out with a fantastic ice cream recipe book, so we're catching up with that, and we are eating ice cream. Dessert first is the New Day policy. Plus, it's Amazing Animal Week, and we start out today with a great dog with some very cute tricks. Totally fun. But first this morning, we're a little bit country and a little bit rock and roll because we have a great gift for one lucky audience member. We hope you love Carrie Underwood as much as we do. Audience coordinator Susie Wiley has details. Susie?
Oh, so exciting. We love Carrie Underwood. So America's country sweetheart and five-time Grammy Award winner Carrie Underwood is releasing Blown Away in stores on May 1st. She's coming to Key Arena in October. She co-wrote 8 of these 14 songs on Blown Away, including Good Girl. And Carrie's buddy Brad Paisley even stepped in with his guitar on one song called Cupid's Got a Shotgun.
I'm sorry, that's very funny.
I can't wait to hear that. And she'll be back on tour this fall. And you are going to draw for a pair of tickets.
She is so gorgeous.
In October to Key Arena. Okay.
Woo!
Here we go.
All right. Good luck, everybody. And the winner is Tia Johnson.
Oh, right there. Tia.
Where's Tia?
Woo-hoo! Are you kidding me? Woo-hoo! Oh, hi.
That's fantastic. Congratulations, honey.
How fun.
I hope. Do you like Carrie Underwood? Do you know who Carrie Underwood is? Kind of, sort of?
Her
not
mom
sure.
Will.
Okay, congratulations. Thank you, Susie. And did I mention not to forget that this Sunday is Mother's Day? Nothing is better than giving a gift that comes from the heart. So here with some fun gift ideas for moms and grandmoms that all have a special touch. Please welcome entertaining expert and chef Heather Christo. Heather, come on out. How you doing?
Hi, sweetheart.
You too.
An early happy Mother's Day to you.
You. So these are wonderful because it honestly, as moms, we both know you love those gifts that your kids spend a little time on that
Absolutely.
Have their little quirks and mm-hmm. funny things that they did with their own hands. So what did you bring?
Absolutely. So I just tried to focus on things that were semi-homemade and affordable so that people
Perfect.
Could, you know, not only put them together themselves and really put their stamp on them, but have it be easy and fun and not breaking the bank.
Exactly. And the kids want to do something, and
Totally.
We want them to be able to do it.
Absolutely. And let's not forget about grandmothers, too.
Yes.
So
good idea.
So here we're going to start with this spa
cute.
Basket I put together. I just got a wooden box down at the hardware store.
Oh, cute.
I painted it and put pretty wrapping paper around it. Really easy.
Mm-hmm.
We've got bath salts that were a combination of Epsom salt, kosher salt, and a little essential oil. This is just brown sugar right now.
Well, that smells really good.
Well, it's about to become a body scrub.
Okay.
So I'm taking some vanilla bean paste. Thank you. But another option would be just to add a whole vanilla bean, you know, with the seeds kind of scraped out.
So you can use this either as an exfoliator or as a dessert.
Or as a snack, yes. Double
either
duty.
One.
This is some grapefruit oil, but grape seed oil, olive
goodness.
Oil, walnut oil, all of those things would be luxurious and great for your skin. And then when you just close it up, you can kind of, we don't want to shake it without the latch. You
okay.
just will
then
shake
just
it up.
Shake it around.
Let it sit. The sugar will absorb it, and it's incredible to do in the shower, like a great body scrub.
Oh my gosh, what a
Could
wonderful
not be easier,
idea.
And it's going to smell so good.
That does. That smells good already. So the
Over
oils
here,
are in here.
We've got grapeseed oil with just a few drops of essential oils for the
mm-hmm.
bath. I also took herbal teas like chamomile and mint.
Oh, that's cute.
And you just put like a little sticker on here. Now you have bathtub tea.
Yeah.
And because you did so many homemade things, it's okay to stick a splurge like a pretty candle or a home fragrance in there.
That's wonderful. And look, you've got a little tiny scoop for the
Scooper
bath
salt. Scooper for the bath salt.
That's
so right.
cute. Mom will love that. Okay.
Okay.
What are we
so
looking
next,
at here?
Gardening kit.
Mm-hmm.
I am a gardener. I would love this. My own mother is. I took this lunch
pail. I'm a plant murderer, so I know nothing about this, but go ahead. Not on purpose.
For those you know that love to garden, I picked this up at my local grocery store. So something like this, you know, or even just a great box. Mm-hmm. I spray painted this one with chalkboard paint. So it let me customize it. I just wrote mom on the front.
You know, that's great.
You could decorate the whole thing however you want.
With whatever color she loves.
Yeah, absolutely. And then I just stuck some fresh herbs in here, which also, grocery store, they're like $3 right now. Mm-hmm. These I got at the drugstore. This is nothing crazy. And the gardening gloves, some seeds. And then this is my favorite part. Bless my husband. He made this with my four-year-old daughter. And you can buy these kits. No,
don't worry about it. I can't even do this.
You can buy these anywhere. And it's really, or just make your own. It's cement, like, you know, with some cooking spray, put in a little plastic mold.
And then she painted it.
Yeah.
That is super
sweet. My favorite thing right now.
All right. And everybody likes to grow herbs.
Yeah, sure.
I can do that most of the time.
So this is a homemade recipe book. It was a photo album.
Yeah,
they make such great
ones. Little sleeves, like, you know, you slip photos in.
Exactly. Like, how many of you guys either have a disaster like this at home that's yours, or your mom, or your grandma has one? A few years ago, my mother, who had like six of these, I went in and stole them in the middle of the night and put them all together in a book, and she cried, you know, because it's real, and it's all of, you know, like my grandmother's cookie recipes. If you lose those, they're gone forever. So take good care, especially of your family recipe. You can add your own favorite recipes that she loves. You know, maybe a neighbor has a pound cake that she's always been obsessed with. Call and get the recipe.
And this is like an heirloom afterwards, because
you can pass the whole thing down.
That's
exactly right.
That's great. That's a great idea, because I actually have a whole bunch of those
so
and scraps of paper printed out of Epicurious whatnot, so
absolutely.
It's a disaster.
So over here we've got homemade art. I just went through my children's like drawing and painting pads. I have a 2- and a 4-year-old, and cut out things that I thought were cool, like this one. And then I bought inexpensive frames at the drugstore and just spray painted them with high gloss spray paint for kind of like a faux lacquered effect. Mm-hmm. And these just make awesome pieces of artwork. There's also I confided that I may have taken these off the wall in my husband's office. But these were something a 2-year-old did. So the other option to spray painting your own frame, is to just get basic black. It really, you know, lets the artwork shine.
Well, if you do that also, then it's easier for grouping when you put things in your house.
Absolutely.
You don't have to worry about what matches what. So
there's
I kind of dig that idea.
There's no question. So then this last project was that I took inexpensive vases, just these ceramic things, and I had my 2- and 4-year-old paint them, right? And then on the bottom, you know, happy Mother's Day, love Pia.
That is the best
for the grandmothers.
When you find these things at home years later, they're just as meaningful, if not more, than when you get them for Mother's
Day. No question. So, you know, my 2-year-old did this. These are grocery store roses.
You have a talented 2-year-old, by the way. And you're brave to give a 2-year-old paint. But
there was a lot of plastic
involved. You rock.
So these were $10 roses from the grocery store. I just stuck some fresh mint and lemon balm in there and kind of dress things up.
Isn't that beautiful? And if you went to the florist, you know how much that would cost.
It would not be good.
No.
So, you know, or these lilacs are in season.
Yeah.
Just whatever, you know, creative liberties your children have taken, just pick some blooms and stick them in there. These are our, sorry, spoiler alert, but these are our grandmother presents this year. So, you know, it's something easy. The kids feel involved.
Right.
You know, mothers, grandmothers are going to treasure these items.
They absolutely will. Mm-hmm. I can tell you now that my son is grown, basically. He's a freshman in college. Every time I find some, he made this little ceramic dog. He's not listening. He's not here right now. That is actually fairly frightening, but I just love it. And every time I put it in my closet, so I see it every day. These things
That's
are so
great.
Meaningful. Thank
Absolutely.
You very much.
Thank you.
Thank you, and happy Mother's Day. Please visit our webpage for a link to Heather's site. You really owe it to yourself to go look. She has terrific ideas for cooking and entertainment, and she's awesome, as you can see, and this doesn't cost a fortune, so it's all good.